Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linen Associates with your metals market update for this Tuesday, January 2nd, 2018, getting on to 2:20 p.m. Central Standard Time. Let me welcome you to 2018, and please keep in the back of your mind, this is going to be one of these weeks where volume is probably not going to be what you normally would get. A lot of traders are still out. They come back throughout the week. Your kids are probably, if you have children, they're probably not in school yet. The vacation period is still going on, although some of the colleges are back in the play. But I know in Chicago, the public schools, they're still out. I take public transportation every day. That's the way you get around in a big city. And believe me, it is light volume. As you can see, the gold and silver having good days, copper giving back a little bit today, the dollar index down, and the market, of course, trying to figure out what to do with President Trump's agenda as the new year gets going. Budget talks happen. We're hearing more about the rhetoric on Iran, North Korea, Afghanistan. But the big deal is going to be the budget, and he's going to have meetings tomorrow. There'll be a lot of leaks out of those as he meets with his fellow Republicans, I think, and discusses what the agenda is going to be and how to get things done. As we take a look at a weekly chart of closes for gold, it's gone straight from 1245.20 all the way up today. And as I said, it's going to settle at around 1316.10 because the settlement's known already. Market trades a couple hours after settlement price is determined. When we take a look at this thrust, it's a difficult thrust to watch because it's almost $80 straight on up from that low. Really never gave you a chance. You either threw a dart and you bought it or it just went on you. When you take a look at the daily chart, you can see, show me where you're getting lower, a day where you have a low that took out a previous day. And when you put on the swing line, the way that I created it, you get to see it hasn't had one. So since this low of 1238.30, not one day has a lower low. People looking to buy the breaks have been left out in the cold. When it lets you buy it, you may not want it. It's now spent 3 days over the 100-day average of closes, as you can see, and it's riding the upper Bollinger Band. In fact, it closed today over it. It closed over it on Friday and the day before. So that's 3 days in a row. Why is that important? Typically, markets don't close more than 5% of the time above or below the Bollinger Bands. I have a rule of thumb, and it's all it is a rule of thumb, that when you get successive days, each one of those takes away one of those percentage points. So I'd rate tomorrow a 2% chance of the market closing over the upper Bollinger Band. Does that mean it has to break? Not at all. It just means it moves to the right of it. How much? Well, that I can't tell you. But since the market hasn't had one correction, when it does correct, I don't know where it'll stop on that bit of a down thrust. When you look at slow stochastics, they have embedded. They have transformed themselves. And it took a heck of a rally to do it. But now you have both numbers over 90 on the settlement today, same thing on Friday and the day before. So until the red line closes back under 80, the breaks in the market I teach should be well supported and provide opportunities. That's all. That's all I can say. In the January CME Bitcoin, you can see how this market has gone with higher lows, got over the 18-day average, came out of sideways Bollinger Band, and exploded to the upside. Very typical. Also embedded along the process. Now, when the red line gets under 80, I will not be surprised to see prices try to attack this low. If it can get through that, maybe pull back even to the 18-day average of closes. Getting a much, much better feel for how Bitcoins trade intraday on the 15-minute bar chart. You might ask, why am I not putting up here the daily bars, daily action? Remember, it just started trading December 11th. We've got a ways to go before that. Here's the gold-silver ratio, and it's Feb gold versus March silver. Look at how it came down. And it's back up off the lows, but not by much. So the market at 80 got ahead of itself, and right now you're just getting a bounce in that. You can see how the gold ETF is running with it. 3 days in a row over the upper Bollinger Band, also embedded. the GDX is right at the upper Bollinger Band resistance. It has been embedded until the market takes out 2302. The trend remains up, but you keep your eye when you embed on the red number. As long as it doesn't close back under 80, you are still looking for markets to be what? Find buying support, if you will, on those breaks. In the silver, the battlegrounds become the 200-day moving average of closes in this dark gray. Like the gold, this is an embedded reading now. So it's a question of what happens when the red line, does it start breaking down or just stay above 80? And of course, I always deem the 200-day average important. Will it be important this time? Should be an important resistance. In the copper, you've had the embedded reading. You can see how it's been going. The market is suddenly stalled out. Doesn't mean the trend is over. You do break the pattern of higher lows, higher highs if you take out 326. My eye will be on the red line. If it gets under 80, I'd look for much more of a correction than just that. In the platinum market, the run-up is still overbought. You haven't converted to the point where the red and the blue are going enough days in a row over 80 to say they've embedded. The resistance showed up just a textbook way, the combination of the 100-day average and the upper Bollinger Band. I think this is where the pros are taking money off the table. In the palladium market, you've had the embedded reading. This has been the strongest of the metal markets, and it has been the one that has hugged the upper Bollinger Band more than any of the others. I'll still label that one of the best looking of the charts. Dollar index has fallen apart. And literally, it's began this process when we passed the tax bill right in here, and the market has just been sinking ever since then. And you look at it all, try to put something together with it, and you realize the stock market is still what I call that vacuum cleaner, sucking money up from all the other assets. And now the question is what happens in the first week of the year, but it doesn't tell us anything for the rest of the year. The hardest thing the traders have to understand is you don't have to rush back in. You wait for your chart setups, and you go back to normal trading. When a holiday ends, you don't have to be just chasing. And we discuss that in the research reports that Linen Associates writes for you. Now, one of the things we like to do is tell you we are a boutique firm with many years of experience. My broker is probably the average guy with me here, 25 years on average, maybe 30 in the industry. In the firm, same type of thing. And what we do is we have people that write on all these different categories. And yes, you can choose which categories you'd like to choose. Sometimes a meat trader doesn't care what's going on in the gold market, for example. But weather, really important, be it your natural gas, energy markets, livestock, grains, important. But we have the weather reports tied to the commodity markets, not whether for your local locale are the kids going to have to wear extra clothing tomorrow. Very different way of looking at it. Options trader, you might say, we really cover the options in what we write. If you haven't seen our research, you want to. If you're a client and you're not getting it, let us know. You deserve it. And we will provide that to you free. But if you haven't tried it, we want you to take a look. Either call my staff, you can go to our website. You'll see right on the front page a carousel of free offers. Click any of them. You'll have in the coupon codes there what you can choose and which ones you want to get in the research. We'll be happy to send it to you. You can click up here if you haven't done that before. It's an icon on YouTube. It'll take you right to that page to sign up. And underneath us on many websites says click here for IRIS free information. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I will see you tomorrow.